Psalm 26. Vindicate me, O Lord, for I have walked in my integrity. I have also trusted in the Lord. I shall not slip. Examine me, O Lord, and prove me. Try my mind and my heart, for your love and kindness is before my eyes. And I have walked in your truth, and I have sat with idolatrous mortals. Nor will I go with the hypocrites. I have hated the assembly of evildoers, and I will not sit with the wicked. I will wash my hands with innocence, so I will go about the halls of the Lord. I proclaim with the voice of thanksgiving, and tell of all your wondrous works. Lord, I have loved the habitation of your house, and the place where your glory dwells. Do not gather my soul with sinners, nor my life with bloodthirsty men, in whose hand is a sinister thing, and whose right hand is full of life. But as for me, I will walk in my integrity. Redeem me and be merciful to me. My foot stands in the demon place. In the congregation, I will bless the Lord. Amen.
Church, we really thank God for being with us and for sustaining us and carrying us through and all the way God is with us. As He has rightfully said, I will never leave you nor will I forsake you. So we thank God this morning and we give you all the praise, the glory, the honor, and all the worship. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. And this morning, I would just like to welcome everybody that is in the auditorium. I'd like to welcome everyone that is joining us this morning via live streaming on social media, to all our seniors who are unable to join us and are sharing with us, joining us now live. We just want to welcome you too, and welcome to everybody that is joining us wherever you are this morning. And if you are a father this morning, today is a special day for all fathers, a very happy blessed Father's Day to all our fathers. We love you and we appreciate you and we thank God for you. Hallelujah. Praise God. Now this morning, before we go into the Word of God, it would only be right for us to pray before we enter the Word of God. So if we just bow our heads this morning and we just pray unto the Lord. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Lord God, we give you all the praise. We give you the glory, we give you the honor, we give you the worship. Oh Lord God, we give you thanks, oh Father God. We thank you for this day that you've blessed us, oh Lord God. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your loving kindness, oh God. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, oh Lord God, and pray two or more are gathered in your name. There you are in the midst. We thank you for your presence in our lives this morning. We pray that you bless each and every individual that is, oh Lord God, a part of this service this morning, whether they are yet physically, oh God, or whether they are with us in spirit, watching us, oh Lord God, via live streaming, Father. We pray your blessing upon your people. And Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, I commit every father to you as we celebrate Father's Day this morning, Father God. Lord God, I pray that you bless our fathers. I pray you grant them wisdom. I pray you grant them understanding. I pray you grant them, oh Lord God, enlightenment in the name of Jesus. Lord God, that Father, as men, that they will take their rightful places, oh Lord God, in their homes, Father God. And that, Lord God, they will assume, oh Lord, the responsibility of being the high priest over their homes. Father, we think of, Lord God, the mothers who have had to now, oh Lord God, because of circumstances, oh Lord God, that have had to take the place of being, oh Lord God, a dual parent in their homes. We pray that you bless them. We pray that you give them strength. We pray that you give them courage. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Father God, we pray, Lord God, that you bless the preaching and the reading teaching of your word this morning. In your blessed name, we pray, God's people said, amen, 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 and amen. Well, praise God. Good morning once again, and welcome once again into the presence of the Lord this morning. Now, this morning, being Father's Day, I would like to share with you about honor, the word honor, what it means to honor, and speak to you about the blessings that come to you as a result of honor. And I want to begin this morning in our foundational text in the book of Ephesians, chapter number 6, and I'm going to read through from verses 1 to 3. Hallelujah. Now the Bible says, children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor thy father and mother, which is the first commandment with promise. I want you to underline that. I want you to highlight that. Honor thy father and mother, which is the first commandment with promise, that it may be well with thee, and thou mayest live long on the earth. Now that is what God's word says, that we are to honor our parents. Firstly, obey our parents in the Lord, for this is right. And secondly, to honor thy mother and father, which is the first commandment with promise, that it may be well with thee, and thou mayest live long on the earth. The Amplified Bible puts it like this. It says, children, obey your parents in the Lord as his representatives, for this is just and right. So you see, brothers and sisters in Christ, ladies and gentlemen, may I share with you this morning that your parents represent God in your lives. That is what the Bible is teaching here. So as we obey our parents represent God. And we are to obey our parents. For this is just and this is right. And verse 2 says, honor, esteem and value as precious your father and your mother. This is the first commandment with a promise. My question to you this morning is, how do you esteem and value your parents? Do you take it for granted? Or do you consider them to be people that should be highly honored, that should be esteemed highly, that should be valued as precious? Because as we honor our parents, there is a great blessing that comes our way. As the Bible says, this is the first commandment with promise. We know the Bible in Deuteronomy chapter number 5 gives us 10 commandments. Everybody is familiar with the 10 commandments. Commandment number 1 through 2, commandment number 4 has to do with God. But commandment number 5, which comes to humanity, commandment number 5 has to do with our parents. Commandment number 5 is honor your father and your mother as the Lord your God has commanded you. You see, so honor, the honoring of our parents, it's a commandment from God. God commands it to be so. Why does he command it to be so? That your days may be long and that it may be well with you in the land which the Lord your God is giving you. So you see that? The secret to long life is not just vitamins and living a healthy life and eating healthy and exercising. The secret to long life has to do with honor. Honor your mother and your father. The Bible does not go on to say that because your mother and your father are to be a specific way, therefore you should honor them. So regardless of the status or state of your parents, the Bible commands us, God commands us in his word to honor our mother and honor our father. Because God commands us. And then he goes on to say that it may be well with you in the land of He gives you length of days, that you may live long on the earth, and that it may be well with you in the land that the Lord your God is giving you. So as you honor, God will honor you. Praise God. Commandment number 6 through to commandment number 10 has to do with relationship with our fellow men, relationship with our neighbor. And we all know that the Bible teaches, Jesus teaches us, that the fulfillment of the entire law, the fulfillment of the entire commandments is summed up in the word love. Love begins with God. And then you find that your parents, our parents, through a love relationship, gave birth to us. Now you may perhaps, you may consider, but you know my parents were never in love, or how I was born. Listen, it doesn't matter how you were born. The fact is that God destined you to be born. God purposed for you to be born. You are a product of God's love. That is where it begins. So your parents gave life to you. God connected them, and God knew about you. God knew how you would be born. How you were born is irrelevant. The important thing is that you honor your mother, you honor your father, regardless of their circumstances. I don't care. Your mother could be a prostitute or an alcoholic, or your father could be a drug addict. It doesn't matter who they are. It doesn't matter whether they're rich, whether they're poor. The Bible says you honor them. He says that you honor them. This is a commandment with promise. And what is the promise? God promises to give you long life. That means that even if sickness or disease were to come your way, you would outlive it because of honor. That means that whatever challenge would come your way, you would overcome it because of honor. Honor will give you positioning. It will give you, it gives you right positioning with God. And God will give you positioning in life that you'll be over the circumstances of life. People will even begin to question your life and ask, how is it possible that you thrive? How is it possible that you flourish? How is it possible that you make it? How is it possible that you are where you are? It is because of the word honor. When you honor your parents, you honor God, and God honors you. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. It is really amazing when you consider some folk. They can honor, they honor other people higher than their parents. And that should not be so. It begins with your parents. How you treat your parents, how you value your parents, determines your value for the lives of others. Praise God. Hallelujah. God says that it may be well with you. In other words, the affairs of life will go well with you because of honor. And you will live a long life. Praise God. Now the word honor, translated in the Old Testament from the Hebrew, is a Hebrew word, kabod. Kabod means to make or to cause to be heavy. It means to be weighty. It means to be rich. It means to glorify. It means to promote. That is what it means. It means to promote. Hallelujah. It's amazing how you find some folk, they are ashamed of their parents. And that's really sad. Even when you consider how they treat their parents, it is a shame the way they treat their parents. Some people are ashamed because of the way their parents look. Now let me share with you something. If you are ashamed, that means that you have done nothing to honor them. You should do everything possible to honor them, to promote them, promote their well-being, promote their prosperity, and God will promote you. Many of you want to be promoted in life. You want to be promoted probably in your workplace. You want to be promoted in business. But the doors are shut wide because of this honor. Hallelujah. The Greek word for honor, as we read in the book of Ephesians 6, the Greek word timao. Timao means to revere. It means to estimate or to fix a value to something or to somebody. Hallelujah. The dictionary describes the word honor as such. To have high respect or great esteem. To have high respect or great esteem. To regard somebody with the greatest of respect. The second definition is the quality of knowing and doing what is morally right. In other words, to fulfill an obligation or to keep agreement. We are obliged to honor brothers and sisters. We are obliged to honor. Why? Because God commands it. When we honor our parents, when we honor our mothers and our fathers, when we give them honor, we begin to agree with God concerning His word. Hallelujah. The Bible says, can two walk together unless they be in agreement? So God commands that we honor, and as we walk in honor, we are actually walking in agreement with God, and that means that we are in partnership with God, and that means that God will have your back regardless of circumstances. Praise God. Amen. Now your parents were the ones, or the agents rather, whom God used to give you life. Amen. If it weren't for your parents, you wouldn't be there. If it weren't for your parents, you wouldn't be breathing today. So God, when God called your parents, when God put them together, He knew that they would have the right DNA to create you. Hallelujah. And God called them, and when God called them, God mantled them. He mantled something upon them so that they can impart that to you, which will carry you through life. I'm going to repeat that. When God called your parents, be the parent, be the father, be the mother. I'm speaking to parents as well this morning. The fact that you are a mother, the fact that you are a father, that is a calling that God has called you to. Amen. That is a calling. And when God called you, when God calls you, He equips you. And how does He equip you? He empowers you. He mantles you. He puts something upon you to impart into your children. Hallelujah. And that which you impart is what will carry them through life. And the greatest gift that any parent could give to any child is not a house, is not money, is not wealth. It's nothing material. The greatest gift that any parent could give to any child is a blessing. And that's what I want to share with you this morning, brothers and sisters. The greatest gift we could ever receive from our parents is not anything material. It's not money. It's not investment. It's not a business. It's not a fancy car. It's not a house. Because those things will perish. That which does not perish is the blessing that you receive from your parents. You know, many young people, you find they live how they want to live. And they decide to, you find some young people, they tell the parents, listen, whether you like it or not, I'm going to get married. With or without your blessing. Let me remind you something this morning, friend. In order for that marriage to thrive, in order for any marriage to thrive and to be successful, it's determined by the blessing that you receive from your parents. It's determined by the blessing. If you do not have the blessing, what's the opposite of blessing? It means your marriage is cursed. That's what it means. If you don't have a blessing, it means it's good. You find things will always be up and down in your marriage. You find even in your life, if you do not honor your parents, there's a blessing in honoring your parents. If you dishonor your parents, you'll never be blessed. That's a guarantee. That's a guarantee. Because God's word says that if you honor them, you'll have long life and it will go well with you. So that means if you dishonor them, your life will be shortened and it will not go well with you. So maybe if you look at your life this morning and consider your life, consider yourself, how did you treat your parents? If your parents are not alive now, how did you treat them? Maybe you may feel hurt, but praise God, you can ask God to forgive you. You can ask God for the grace to let go of. Hallelujah. If your parents are still alive, today is an opportunity that you can make things right. You know, I had an opportunity to speak to a non-believer. I was having a conversation with a non-believer, a Muslim man, who shared with me, and he shared this, and he's a very influential businessman. And he said this to me. He says, you know, Pastor Ricardo, I want to share something with you. The day my mother died, because his dad died when he was still very young, he said, the day my mother died, my blessing stopped. And I asked him, I said, what do you mean? Can you expound on this a little more? And he says, you know what, when my mother was alive, I would send her a blank check, which I signed. I'd send her a blank check every month. At the end of the month, I signed the check, I send it to her, and I tell her, whatever you need, you fill in the mark, you fill in the digits. And he says his business thrived. And then the day his mother passed on, the day she died, his blessings died. But then he shared with me something, that he looked for somebody else that he could bless in the place of his mother. And he found that things began to work for him. So that means that there's a principle that God has instituted. It's the principle of honor. If you want things to go well in your life, if you want things to go well, probably I'm speaking to business people now, or I'm speaking to professional people, if you want things to go well for you, it begins with honor. Amen. As you honor, God will honor you. Let me share something with you. In the book of Genesis, chapter number 27, let me show this to you. Genesis 27. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Genesis 27, and I want to read verse 4. This is Isaac. And in verse 4, he's speaking to his son Esau. And he says to him, he says, make me savory food such as I love, and bring it to me that I may eat, that my soul may bless you before I die. In verse 10, we find Rebecca speaking to Jacob. She says, she now instructs Jacob to go and get the meat, and she would, you know, he should go to the flock and get a goat, and she would prepare the food that Isaac loves. And then she says in verse 10, that you shall take it to your father that he may eat it, and that he may bless you before his death. And that is what kept Jacob for his entire life, was the blessing. So when you receive your blessing from your parents, that blessing will carry you. That blessing is the root. That wherever you are, because of the blessing, you will prosper. And that is the definition of blessing. the blessing, it is an empowerment given to you to prosper. That wherever you are, you will prosper because of the blessing. Wherever Jacob went, he was blessed. He went to the house of Laban, he was blessed. Hallelujah. Even when there was famine in the entire world, because of that blessing worked in his life, and it spilled off into the lives of his children. Amen. We find Jacob in Genesis 48, he blesses the sons of Joseph. In Genesis 49, he invokes words of prophecy and blessing over his sons. So it is important, brothers and sisters in Christ, that we receive the blessing and not the curse. Hallelujah. Even when we look at another aspect of Jacob's life, Jacob went, he lived with his father-in-law. Even though his father-in-law robbed him, but we find that Jacob still honored Laban. Regardless of what Laban did to Jacob, he still honored him. We find that Moses honored his father-in-law, Jethro. Hallelujah. He honored Jethro. We find it in the life of Ruth. Ruth honored her mother-in-law, Naomi. Were it not for honor to Naomi, she would never have met Boaz. I mean, Ruth became the grandmother of King David. She's mentioned in the lineage of our Savior Jesus Christ. Why? Because of honor. So we ought to honor our parents. We ought to honor our parents in law. Praise God. Hallelujah. And the opposite, I want to look at the opposite now. Look at Noah's sons. In the book of Genesis, chapter number 9. Genesis chapter 9. Praise God. Genesis chapter 9. And I want to read from verse. Praise God. Genesis chapter 9. Verse 20. And Noah began to be a farmer, and he planted a vineyard. Then he drank of the wine and was drunk, and became uncovered in his tent. And Ham, the father of Canaan, saw the nakedness of his father and told his two brothers outside. But Shem and Japheth took a garment, laid it on both their shoulders, and went backward and covered the nakedness of their father. Their faces were turned away, and they did not see their father's nakedness. So Noah awoke from his wine and knew what his younger son had done to him. Then he said, cursed be Canaan, a servant of servants, he shall be to his brethren. And he said, blessed be the Lord, the God of Shem, and may Canaan be his servant. May God enlarge Japheth, and may he dwell in the tents of Shem. And may Canaan be his servant. Hallelujah. So you see that? What happened is, Ham, the son of Noah, he uncovered his father's nakedness. And he mocked his father. So that is what you do. When you dishonor your parent, when you dishonor your mother, when you dishonor your father, you are uncovering the nakedness. You should be covering them. A true son. A true daughter covers, does not put to shame, does not look at faults and look at flaws. You find many young people today, they're always complaining about their parents. Yeah, but my mother's like this. Yeah, my father's like this. But yeah, no, that is not your place. That is God's place. God has called you to do one thing, and that one thing is to honor, so that you may receive the blessing. When we look at Miriam, Moses' sister, in the book of Numbers, chapter number 12, we find in verse number 1, she was speaking, they were speaking about Moses. And then you find in verses 10 through to verse 15, God's judgment comes upon her. And she becomes leprous. You see that? She becomes leprous. The Bible says that she was put out of the camp. So she was put out of the camp, that she may not enjoy the benefits that were within the camp. So dishonor takes gets you out of what God truly has in store for you, of what God desires you to partake of. This honor puts you outside, but honor brings you inside. Honor causes you to partake. Honor causes you to really enjoy the fruits of the blessing that God has in store for you. Hallelujah, praise God. We look at the son of David in the book of 2 Samuel, chapter number 15. Absalom turns against his father David. And he becomes king now. He takes the throne by force. But we find God's judgment comes upon him in 2 Samuel chapter 18 and verse number 9. As he's riding, his hair gets caught in a bough in a tree. And the mule goes and he starts hanging. He was dangling in the air by his hair. You see, that is a prideful mind. A prideful mind. The Bible says pride comes before destruction. Hallelujah. Praise God. So do not be proud. I want to share with you quickly in closing Proverbs chapter number 20. Proverbs 20 and verse number 20. Proverbs 20, 20. Hallelujah. Wow. 2020. And that is the year that we are actually celebrating. Thank you, Lord Jesus. The Bible says, whoever curses his father or his mother, his lamp will be put out in deep darkness. You see that? Whoever curses his father or his mother, his lamp will be put out in deep darkness. Right now, we're facing a pandemic worldwide, a worldwide pandemic. And I begin to question. And I look at this scripture. And I began, speaking to the Lord. And I believe this is what God is saying. That it's time that the rebellion stopped in the lives of our young people. And it's not a house can never function with the children dictating to the parents how the house should run. It is the parents who dictate to the children. And it is the children who must respond in obedience. It is the children who must honor. Give honor to whom honor is due. Praise God. As you honor, I believe it will be well with you. So what God is saying here is that if you can honor your parents, you'll even outlive Corona. Because he says you'll have long life, your days will be long. So it begins with honor. So that's my question to you. Have you given honor? Are you giving honor to your parents? And God is calling us back. He's giving us in this time a time to reflect on our relationship. Before your relationship can be right with anybody, your relationship must be right with God first. It starts with God. And once your relationship is right with God, then your relationship is right with your parents. You cannot dishonor your parents and still claim to be serving God, because then you are a hypocrite. It begins with God and then it goes to your parents. You've got to honor your parents. You cannot claim to be serving God, but you are not honoring your parents. The two go hand in hand. Your parents represent God in your life. So this is what God is saying. Go back to honor. Give honor to your parents. Because when your relationship is now right with your parents, then your relationship will be right with your fellow men. That is the order. It's God first, then your parents, and then your fellow man. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. I told you that the whole of the commandments is summed up in the word love. What is the opposite of love? Hatred. So that means if you honor your parents, that is how you show them love. It is not based on what your parents can do for you. It is not based on that. When you honor your parents, that is how you show them love. It's through honor. But if you dishonor him, then, my friend, you are not walking in love, but you are walking in the opposite of love. Then you are walking in hatred. And God is not a God of hatred. The Bible says God is love. And once you have God, you have love. The love of God has been shed abroad in our hearts by the precious Holy Spirit. And once you have that love restrains you. That love compels you. That you can only but love. You can only but honor. You can only but serve. So that's my message to you this morning, is to go back to honor. If you want things to go right in your life, honor. Honor, honor, honor. Honor is the key. Honor will open doors. There are many, I see this morning, there are many of you, the doors have been shut because of this honor. And I believe that God will open those doors if you just step into honor. Become a man of honor. Become a woman of honor. Become a person of honor. Hallelujah. Can you say that with me this morning? I'm a person of honor. And because you walk in honor, God will honor you. Praise God. Glory to God in the highest. Amen. And I trust this morning that you've received something. I trust this morning that you take this key of honor and you use this key, and I believe it will unlock many a door in your life. Praise God. Can we stand this morning as we close? Hallelujah, our service. Just quickly before I release the final prayer and blessing, I would like to share with those of you that are watching to please register. The details are on the screen. Register if you'd like to attend our services. Register. The details are appearing on the screen. Connect with us. Amen. And just share with us what the Lord is doing in your life. And if you have a prayer request, send it to us. Amen. We love you. We pray for you always. And God, just register for our services, because during this time, as you know, we're limited to seating. So that allows us to plan appropriately for our services and for our meetings. Amen. So just register. Details on the screen, send us a WhatsApp, send us an SMS. We love you. We look forward to having you join us or visit us. It is always an honor to meet God's people. Amen. Hallelujah. And just quickly before I close, if you are 60 years and older and there are children 13 years and younger, unfortunately, we love you. And we appreciate you. We understand you love to be with us, but we wouldn't want to put you at risk, so we request that you join us via the live stream. And anybody with any underlying medical condition, we advise you to join us via the live stream. And the rest of you, we invite you to come join us. It's always good to have you in the house of God, to have fellowship with you. Our Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I commit into your hands, Lord God, every person, every individual, Lord, in this auditorium, and those watching us via social media, whatever platform. I pray that your blessing will come upon them. I pray that in blessing you will bless them, and multiply, that you multiply them, in Jesus' blessed name. Father God, I pray that your hand of protection will be upon your people. Cover them, O Lord God, with the precious blood of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord and Savior. I thank you, Lord, O God, that we walk in divine health. I thank you, Lord, O God, we walk, O Lord God, in the divine providence and protection of God Almighty. In Jesus' blessed name, I pray that you keep your people, O Lord God, in the palm of your hand, that you protect them from the evil one. I thank you that no weapon formed against them shall prosper. I thank Thank you that it shall be well with them, it shall be well with their children, it shall be well with their families, it shall be well with their marriages, in the name of Jesus. Lord God, those who are sick, oh Lord God, Father God, we pray in the name of Jesus, that they be healed in Jesus' name. Father, we command that they be healed. We thank you in the name of Jesus, according to your word, by the stripes of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we were healed. And I speak healing over your people this morning in Jesus' blessed name. And I pray that this week will be a week, O Lord God, of divine happenings in Jesus' name. May uncommon favor, Lord God, visit your people in Jesus' blessed name. We give you all the praise, the glory, and the honor both now and forevermore. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Ghost rest and abide with each and every one of you, both now and forevermore, in Jesus' blessed name. And God's people said, amen, 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 amen. And praise God. Hallelujah. God bless you. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus.